rectangular components of a vector. Any vector can be divided into its two components. One is vertical component and another is horizontal component. Both components are perpendicular to each other. Vertical components are also called sine component and the horizontal components are also called cos component. These components give us idea about the net effective vector acting in horizontal or in vertical direction. So let us see an example. Let us see the components of this vector F. Let F be any vector acting in any direction. So to find the component of vector F, we will draw the horizontal and a vertical line such that both lines are perpendicular on each other. So the horizontal axis will be the F cos theta and it will be the horizontal component of this vector F. And F sin theta will be the vertical component of the vector F, where F is the magnitude of this vector. And theta is the angle made by this vector F with the horizontal axis. So let us see the magnitude of F. What will be the magnitude of F? So magnitude of the vector F will be denoted as modulus of F equals to F cos theta square plus F sine square theta, because here this is on 90 degree, both are perpendicular on each other. So when we solve it, F square cos square theta plus F square sin square theta over root, then we get finally F, and this will be the magnitude of this vector F. Similarly, if we take any vector such as V like this, then in this case also we can break its this vector into two components. One is horizontal and another is vertical. The horizontal component is V cos theta, and this theta is the angle made by this vector V with this horizontal axis, and this is the V sin theta, where V is the magnitude of this vector. So in this way we can find components of any vector.